All right. Careful consideration is going to be the pick for us over Mindstone, I think. Mindstone is pretty reasonable. But we don't really have, let's see, we're on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so we're on 18 cards, and that's including Corpse Dance and Diabolic Servitude, so I think we need some more substantial hits, and careful consideration is going to be that, plus with Talrand, et cetera, you know. Ooh, Elishnorn, Imperial Seal, Diabolic Edict. Elishnorn is something. Kind of want to just take Diabolic Edict, though. Just because, let's see, are we actually, yeah, I mean, all right, let's hide this Diabolic Servitude. Hide this Corpse Dance. Yeah, sure, Bane of the Living, vomit. Hate that card. Might not be playing, or, yeah, not playing Curse Catcher either. I think Edict is probably going to be the way to go. I don't really see this wheeling, but, you know, I don't really see Imperial Seal being as nearly as good, unless we can go all in on Talrand, but I think if Talrand is in our controlled, our solid control deck, that's gonna end up being better. Ooh, Skin Render. Can play that. Maybe the Slaughter Pact will wheel. Skin Render most definitely will not wheel. Let's see, what else is here? Any more Dream Halls cards? Not really. I mean, yeah. Skin Render. Rah! Kill him. Kill him dead. And Balance? Is Balance good with Talrand? Like, sort of combos. Academy Ruins with no artifacts except for Mox Diamond. It's also good. If we have Shield Rid, we can reanimate Ulamog. We just take Koth. Koth will be pretty problematic. We take Balance. Yeah, Balance doesn't seem like it's the worst. We don't have too many creatures, so. Yeah, sure, Balance it is. Celestial Purge, Liliana. Liliana does not seem like it's going to be that great. We do have a Scrubland, and that's it for for special swamp fixing. Take Pernicious Deed. That would have been a good reason to take a green fetch land, or a green dual land rather. But Celestial Purge is probably going to be better since we can kill Koth with that. And Phyrexian Razor versus Temple Garden. Likelihood that we wield Deed, unlikely. Let's see, where are our spells right now? I think we probably need this Phyrexian Razor. Let's check. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's just count our lands. 7, so we're at 19. Yeah, Phyrexian Razor is probably coming in there. We might even be able to blink it. Ooh, that'd be cool, wouldn't it? Buried Alive or Bloodghast, Shieldred. Take Sublime Archangel. That makes Lingering Souls better. We can just take Hex Parasite and kill Planeswalkers. I don't really see boarding this in very often, though. It does kill Planeswalkers pretty well. Bring in Bloodghast to go aggro. Doesn't seem that bad. We don't have too many guys, though, so let's just go ahead and take Buried Alive. Prophetic Bolt, checking sources. No steam vents, we didn't take that, just Mox Diamond. So, probably gonna be taking Makeshift Mannequin. Yeah. And Silent Spectre for the sideboard. Oh, my phone is ringing. Those telemarketers are calling me again, so. Where were we? Yes, short on a few playables. Well, maybe that's not necessarily the case. I don't know if we're gonna be playing this balance. We might end up playing it. We could cut some creatures. Not gonna be playing this mannequin. Let's take a look at everything again. Hide green. All right, moving on. Let's see. Can't possibly cast Sigarda. We cast Raging Ravine. Can we attack with Raging Ravine? Never. Hendrick Stomp Howler, Ancient Grudge, Nether Reliquary. All of these are terrible. Let's go with Ancient Grudge. Draw our Mox Diamond every single time. Yeah, I can get behind that. All right. We have here a Rishadan port, I think. Not going to be porting, but we might sight it in. It's entirely possible. Okay, Dark Ritual or Stomping Grounds? I think we're going to bring in Stomping Grounds because it casts Ancient Grudge pretty well. And we'll take this Reckless Charge. So I don't really see using Cabal Coffers in this type of deck. Ooh, Temple Garden? Man, this just. The hits don't stop. Okay, so our deck is kind of meh. I give us a. This is about a. Yeah, this is a suboptimal deck. But we do have a few counter spells. So we should do okay. And by okay, I mean this is going to be a bit of a grind. And if I make it past round one, that'll be interesting. Ooh, Mold Chandler. We can actually cast that. Kicked. Because we have Stomping Ground and Temple Garden. Alright, so we have virtually no sideboard. We have a Buried Alive, a Corpse Dance, a makeshift mannequin, and not very many good utility creatures. I mean, Buried or Corpse Dance plus Shielder doesn't really work out too well. So I'm going to be running this just the Diabolic Servitude for value. And that combos with basically Silent Spectre. Let's see, it's Morph. So Silent Spectre, Talrand, Skin Render, Graveborn Muse, Moloku. Doesn't really work out too well with Aeon Chronicler or Bane of the Living or Fathom Seer. So it works about with half of our spell or creatures. A little bit over. And I'm gonna be running Maze of Ith in place of the 23rd spell. I mean, it is a spell in itself. And then it also combos well since we're running 18 lands for Mox Diamond. And we have a bunch of fixing. We have Underground River, we have Caves of Qualos, Isolated Chapel, Scrubland, and Marsh Flats. So two pain lands, which I'm not really happy with, but what are you gonna do? You cannot run them. But I would rather just be able to fix my mana. So taking a look at, we can see that Fathom Seer is going to be pretty awkward since we only have Forspike, Mana Leak, Esper Charm, Careful Consideration, Tidings, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 blue spells. And taking a look at our stats, we can see that we have a lot of black mana symbols. Although the split between blue and black is almost even, slightly ahead in favor of black. If you take a look at the average color on the curve, we're gonna want more black sources than not. So that means that means we're gonna have 8 islands and 12 swamps, and the rest are non-basics. Fortunately, all of our non-basic fixing makes black mana, so that means we can run a lot of islands, which means the Fathom Seer is better. We're running only 5 blue or white sources, including the Mox Diamond, so we may actually want to take out an island for another plains, but that's only bad for something like Mana Tithe. And so I think we can actually just try it like this. So we'll try this and hopefully it works out because, gee, this was a little more difficult to build than I really wanted it to be. So we'll see you during round one.